Hello, everyone. My name is Moses, and I'm one of the pastors of RWC. Today, I'm so excited because I get to share a few words with you guys. And so before I get started, I would like to start with a prayer. So wherever you are, just please join me in this prayer. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you, God, for the opportunity that we have to know about you, Jesus, and to share just a few words with our friends and family. Lord, my prayer is simple. Lord, I pray that we will be obedient to the word, that we'll be able to obey your word to the fullest, Lord. Lord, I pray, Lord, that it will bear much fruit, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. So like I was saying, I'm very excited to share, and I would like to start with reading two verses in Matthew chapter 6, which is the Lord's Prayer. And before I begin, I would like to give you a little bit of context. This is a time where the disciples were asking Jesus, please teach us how to pray. And Jesus, being such an amazing teacher, he began to teach them. And in Matthew chapter 6, verse 9, it reads like this. So Jesus said, "This then is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, may your holy name be honored. May your kingdom come, and may your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." Can I read that one more time, the latter part? And it says, "May your kingdom come, may your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." I'm sure you've read this and cited this so many times. At least here in the Diaz household, we read this every night. We pray this prayer every night. Actually, my two-year-old Olivia could pray this prayer, and it's probably the most cutest thing to see and to hear. And what I'm trying to get with this is that there are times that, because we recite these things so many times, these prayers, we've taken these words for granted. And imagine for a minute that we, when we pray, we really apply these words. God, may your kingdom come. May your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That's powerful. Imagine if we apply faith to that. And so I would like to define the word kingdom, the Greek word, which the word is basileia, which refers to the reign of a king, our king. So once again, if you apply this, right, if you apply "let your kingdom come," it's literally saying, God, be king over, be ruler and reign over whatever the situation is. Doesn't that sound a bit powerful? For me, when I thought about it, I cringe on the thought that God will take over my situation. So there are two things, two primary realms where God could be rule and reign, could be ruler and reign. One is personal. See, the moment we get close to God, the moment we pray to God, God, let your kingdom come. Lord, be ruler over my situation. Be ruler over me. We're allowing God to, it's a personal, we're allowing God to take control of oneself. And that alone is powerful. The moment we get close to God and we say, God, let your kingdom come. Let your will be done. No, not my will. Let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That applies power to your prayer. It truly does. It truly does. The second component that "let your kingdom come" applies is also in our neighborhood, in our city, and even in our nation. Just think about our current state, how everyone is in isolation. You know, I've been blessed to have such a great family and friends around me, and I'm not alone. But those that do feel alone, those that don't have anything, those that've lost employment, when we pray, Lord, let your kingdom come, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven, is also praying for those. Lord, be ruler, be king over our nation. Be ruler, be king over our government, over our city, over the present state of so many people that are hurting, so many people that are burdened, so many people right now that don't know how to get their next meal. When we pray that prayer, that power, the power of those words goes beyond our own house. Isn't that powerful? Isn't that powerful? So as I close today, like I said, this is very, very simple. Very simple, few words. But as I close today, I want you guys to be able to marinate on these few words. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So as I close, can you join me in this prayer? Lord, today I affirm, Lord, that you are sovereign over all creation. There is no one truly like you. Jesus, thank you for Matthew chapter 6. Jesus, thank you because you teach us how to pray. So today I pray, Lord, that you be ruler over my house, that you be the king and ruler over our nation. Lord, that you be king and ruler over our present situation, Lord. Lord, I pray, Lord, for those that don't know where they're going to get their next meal, Lord. Lord, that you'll be ruler over them, that your kingdom will reign over them, Lord. Lord, I pray for those that are sick, Lord. Lord, and my prayer, Lord, is that you'll be king and ruler over them, Lord. That your kingdom come, Lord, over their hearts, over those that are sick. Lord, there's no one sick in heaven, Lord. So I pray, Lord, that just as it is in heaven, Lord, let it be done here on earth, Lord. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Amen. Well, guys, I am blessed to learn about God, and I just want to thank you guys for just tuning in and listening. Our simple words. So take care, be blessed, and I'll see you guys next time.